Okay, so you need to know how to make a tiny URL. First, you want to launch the website, Kel. Go to www.tiny.cc. That's it. And this is the website that you will find. Now let's say that you want to take a, the show URL from the Pampered Chef's website. So I'm in Pampered Chef's, you know, Consultant's Corner behind one of my shows, and right here is the link that they have created for this particular host's show. So go ahead and copy it like normal. Then go ahead and highlight it, copy it, and just leave it there. And then come over here to the Tiny URL website. Now there's three things I want you to look at. One is the big box here, which is where you're going to actually paste that long URL in there. The little box down here that's kind of grayed out says customer one. You're going to actually customize your URL there. And here I like to use this because when you click on this, after you've, you know, you create everything, click on this, create it, it'll actually track the people, you know, how people click on it. I've only looked at it once so far. There is another one of these websites, but I find I like this one a little better. It's a little nicer and it does have this tracking part to it where the other one doesn't. So anyway, just right click and paste that long URL in there. I click here and then here you just, you know, type it in whatever you want it to be. So it could be, let's see, I already made one for this actual particular host. I can't make another one for them with the same name, so we'll just call it Kim's Party Page. How's that? Kim's Party Page. Just for, you know, for today. Anyway, so again, go ahead and click Tiny. So there's the long URL. There is my customized URL. I went ahead and clicked the log stats for this URL that I'm making, and I make it. So now that I've made it, here's what has come up. So what you want is right here. See this? It just highlighted it for me when I touched it. I didn't click on it. And it's longer than it shows, but all you want to do is right click and then copy it. So now I've got it, and it's permanent now. You don't have to worry about saving it. It'll always be there. And then let's say you want to go into an email and send this host her link. So you can say, you know, hi, Kim. I wanted to send you a short link that you can share with your friends to visit your Pampered Chef host page easily. Oops, I know, quick here, easily. Let's see, you can copy and paste this link into an email, a personal message on Facebook, or even into a text message. And then I would say paste it right there. And now I'm going to make it a hyperlink of its own because I can in Gmail. I'm going to come down here and there it is. Throw it in there. Now you see how it brought up the tiny URLs, you know, the whole thing right here, which is nice. Because now all they have to do is really just watch, you know, click on it, and look what it'll do. It takes them right to their Pampered Chef show page. Now this is what the guests see, not the host, but this is really cool because this is, you know, how she can easily share this with her friends right here. And there's everything that I would have put in there for that. So now that's how I do it in an email, in Evernote. Let's say here is that save the date that I send out. This is the instructions portion, the top portion, telling the host what to do. Under the line here is what she will actually copy and paste to her friends into an email, a personal Facebook message, whatever. But I want to go ahead and add that same link. So I'll say, you know, want a sneak peek? Check out my online host page. And then go ahead and just right click and paste it here as well. Now in Evernote, you can also make it a link by highlighting it, right clicking and coming up to hyperlink, and then clicking add, and then just tell it, a lot of times I have to paste it in there, but that's pretty nice that it put it there itself. Click OK, and there it is. So if she actually just does this, you know, and she copies that section and goes into her email and does this, watch this. It actually puts that link in there for her, and it is active for her. So see, she didn't have to do anything special. You don't have to tell her to do anything special, but it's already there. And then she can go ahead and then address and send it out. And this is where I want her to not forget to put me in with her, you know, we were in Evernote, weren't we? That's right. This is where I want her to add my email address along with everybody else's and not blanket copy it, so that everybody gets it, you know what I mean? And then the other thing I think you might have wanted to know was back in Evernote, this is that first email that I send to the host where I've actually attached several links, but like this is the page right here that has that save the date in it. So, you know, if she clicks there, it's going to take her to this with the instructions. You can do that. I've done that. I like doing it that way. But that's pretty much it. I don't know if there was anything else that you would want to know, but you can go ahead and copy and paste that link into here anywhere you would like to. Anyway, if you have any more questions, just let me know, and I will.